Hello. Today we will talk about ADMM, Alternating Directions Method of Multipliers. The method is dedicated to solution of constraint optimization problem when the objective function is separable. So our variables constitute two sets, X and Z. So the objective is sum of two convex functions, and the vector constraints, equality constraints, is a linear function of those two variables. Before watching this video, one should be familiar with the penalty multiplier or augmented Lagrangian methods, and the best reference is to watch my previous video, penalty function and augmented Lagrangian methods 2013. We will start with the writing augmented Lagrangian for our problem, which is the objective function plus Lagrange multipliers y vector transpose the vector of constraints H. Those terms constitute usual Lagrangian. And also we add another term, penalty parameter rho divided by 2, multiplied by a norm of the vector of equality constraints. Standard augmented Lagrangian or penalty multiplier methods, we would minimize at every iteration, we would minimize our augmented Lagrangian in X and Z jointly, and then update multipliers. In ADMM, the process is slightly different. It's more simple. We just minimize augmented Lagrangian in X. Then, from obtained point, fixing X, we minimize it in Z, and then update multipliers by standard formula for augmented Lagrangian. Pay attention that with those two sequential minimizations in X and then in Z, we do not get to the minimum in both variables at the same time, in both groups of variables. Nevertheless, when the objective is convex, when f and g are convex functions and h is linear, it may be proven that the whole process converges, and this give rise to many efficient applications of ADMM. The efficiency typically comes from the fact that optimization in X and separate optimization in Z may be carried in a much more efficient way than joint optimization. Quite often, as we will see in the example of Lasso problem, for example, it even may be carried analytically. Now we will demonstrate use of ADMM for solution of Lasso problem. Finding a linear least square solution which achieves sparsity, as small as possible number of non-zeros, and usually it is achieved by adding L1 penalty term to the least square objective. In order to use ADMM, we will introduce artificial variable Z and have constraint Z equal X. And instead of norm one of X, we will put norm one of Z. Then our augmented Lagrangian may be written as f of x, which is like here in general form, plus g of z, it will be L1 norm of z, which is written here, plus y transpose multiplied by vector of constraints, x minus z, plus penalized to square root 2 norm of constraints. ADMM iteration will look as following. We first minimize our augmented Lagrangian in X. So to do so, we think about Z as a constant. Write down gradient in X. In X, we have only quadratic terms. Gradient in X of this expression and equate it to zero. It's easy to see that this will be the solution of our problem. In order to minimize in Z, while X is constant, pay attention that the function in Z is separable. For example, L1 norm of Z is just sum of absolute values of Z. Linear term is also sum of elements Zi multiplied by Yi. Each component depends only on Zi. The same can be said about L2 norm term. That's why for every component Zi, we will solve one-dimensional scalar optimization problem. And the solution can be achieved analytically, and it's written here. We just take difference between x bar and y divided by rho, vector y divided by scalar penalty parameter rho, and take so-called soft threshold function. I will explain it just in a minute. And after doing those two minimization, we update our multipliers by standard formula, which is written here. It's a new y is old y plus penalty parameter multiplied by vector of constraints. And the soft thresholding function here is a function of one variable, and it can be defined as solution of a scalar optimization problem. Assume we have a parameter u and want to minimize in x half of x minus u squared plus absolute value of x. It is easy to see that when u is positive, the solution will be just u minus lambda plus. Plus mean then the expression is positive, we take itself, and when it's negative, we substitute it by zero. And that's why the name thresholding function. And for negative u, the situation will be just symmetric. So in order to obtain z, to minimize in z, we take a thresholding function with parameter lambda divided by rho.